Hello, stranger. It's been a minute since we last kicked it. And by the way, just got in town, and I won't let you in this cloud. All in the sky, ruin my vibe. Usual. What's up, Scorpio, and welcome to my channel. I hope that all of my beautiful and my powerful, handsome Scorpios out there are doing well. All right, you guys, so I've already shuffled. We got some cards that came out, okay? So as I was shuffling these cards, you guys, I was asking Spirit about this past person, okay? What was this person like in the past, okay? Because the last reading that we talked about someone being very regretful and very remorseful for their past actions, okay? So we pulled some cards here, and we're going to see how this person was in the past, and then we're going to pull future energy. We're going to see how this person has changed or what their current energy is like, okay? So if anything resonates, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment, all right? So the first card we have here is, when I'm not confident with who I am, I will always act superficial, okay? So Scorpio, you could have been dealing with someone who suffered from some self-esteem issues, okay? This is someone who was really not confident within themselves. And this could have been someone who could have been a little bit envious and jealous of you if you were more confident within yourself than they were within them, okay? So this person would act in superficial ways because they really suffered from low self-esteem. So in the past, Scorpio, you could have been dealing with someone who really couldn't keep up in the conversation, okay? So this could have been someone that was used to having surface type conversations. You know, they didn't watch the news. They didn't know things about the world. They wasn't aware of things that was going on, okay? This could have been someone that just, you know, they just was bare living, okay? This is someone who would act real arrogant and real rude, Scorpio, because they really couldn't keep up with the conversation. Because y'all know we deep. We'll get to talking about some old shit, and people be looking at us like, what in the hell? You know, this is someone who really couldn't keep up with the conversation, okay? So this is someone who, I ain't gonna say they wasn't that intelligent, but they weren't that damn deep, Scorpio, okay? Remember, this is somebody who was very superficial. So they didn't look at things from the aspects and the perspectives that you did. You know what I'm saying? They didn't see shit that way. Someone here also did not feel like they were good enough, and they made a lot of excuses, okay? So maybe someone here didn't feel like they were good enough to be in your energy or good enough for you to be around them or good enough to do this and that. So they would make excuses. Oh, I can't come see you. Oh, I can't do this. I can't do that. You know what I'm saying? Because I got, like, this person made a lot of excuses, but I feel like they just didn't feel like they were good enough, okay? Maybe you were trying to show this person, you know, a different world or a different side of shit, you know, change their perspective, but it was like they just didn't feel like they were good enough, okay? We also have someone that's fearful, okay? They learned a behavior at a young age, Scorpio, that can be unlearned, okay? A lot of us, Scorpio, and I'm learning this too, a lot of shit that we learned as kids that we were taught, and a lot of this shit wasn't right, you know what I'm saying? And I know me on my spiritual journey, I had to unlearn a lot of shit that was taught to me as a child. So one, I wouldn't continue to carry on that shit to my kids, and they do it to their kids. Like I guess I was put here to stop this generational curse, you know what I'm saying? But a lot of us had a lot of learned behaviors. You know, we had a lot of things that we were taught at a very young age. And it was like, as we got more into this spiritual realm, we had to realize, like, this shit wasn't right, okay? Also, a low vibrating feeling create limitations for you and your future happiness, okay? So this person was vibing real low. They was low vibrational, okay? This energy has definitely been coming up a lot. And because of this, Scorpio, this created limitations. Like, this person could only be limited. Like, if they worked a job, they can only get so far within their company or their job because they were so low vibration, okay? And this person, this could have been a hardworking man or a hardworking woman. But because of their behaviors, because they were so low vibrational, like, they really couldn't excel. They couldn't succeed. Thank you, Spirit. This person can succeed the way that they wanted to, okay? So I feel like somebody here was always just working their ass off, basically, because it was like they really couldn't climb their ladder the way that they wanted to because they was vibing so damn low, okay? This is someone who really, really wasn't happy, Scorpio. I'm not picking up the energy of someone here being depressed, but it was like they really just weren't happy with their life and how things were. But I feel like this person wasn't able to
accept the fact that maybe it was because of the vibration of the plane they was on, okay? I feel like, Scorpio, in the past, this person couldn't give you what the hell that you needed and you deserve. Why? Because this person was very superficial, okay? This is someone who made a lot of excuses, so they possibly didn't take accountability. And this is someone, Scorpio, who was vibing low. So when you vibing low, even Scorpio, if you was vibing low with this person, I feel like you still was above this person. Like, you still was energetically vibing higher than this person. You know what I'm saying? So this person, because they were low vibration, they can give you what you deserve. You know what I'm saying? But this is someone now, Scorpio, that feels it is not too late, okay? They have not moved on, and this person does want to reconnect because this came out in reverse, okay? So even though this is past energy, this is how this person is feeling now. They don't feel like it's too late. They don't feel like it's never too late for true love. You know what I'm saying? This person has not moved on from you, and they do want to reconnect. This person, Scorpio, couldn't be vulnerable with you in the past, okay? They rather hide their feelings before they let you see them, okay? This person really wants you to see them for who they truly were. So this could have been someone that acted real hard and real macho. But really, Scorpio, this person was like a little marshmallow on the inside. You know what I'm saying? Like them little Sour Patch Kids. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is someone that tried to act all sour and all like them. They really was all sweet and lovable. Probably wanted to be up under your ass all the time, Scorpio, but they didn't want you to see that side of them, okay? We also had, I'm afraid that your feelings for me are not mutual. So this is what this person fears, Scorpio. Now that this person, I feel like, doesn't feel like it's too late for you guys because they have not moved on and because they do want to reconnect, Scorpio, but they fear that these feelings and emotions that they have for you, Scorpio, they feel now that shit is not mutual. You know what I'm saying? I feel like in the past, hell yeah. You know what I'm saying? I feel like in the past, even if she wasn't mutual, because I feel like you was the one that had the feelings and emotions and they didn't. And it's like now, Scorpio, they got the feelings and emotions and you don't. You know what I'm saying? I feel like, Scorpio, because this person did not want to be vulnerable with you, you know what I'm saying? They didn't want you to see that lighter side of them, Scorpio. They never told you that they loved you. Even though this is someone who really did love you, this energy has been coming out a lot as well, okay? Someone here really loved you, Scorpio, and they never told you that, okay? Someone here wasted a lot of time being low vibration, okay? So this person realizes that when they were low vibration out here doing low vibration ass shit in the streets, okay, with their low vibration ass friends, they wasted a lot of damn time because this person really could have been healing. They really could have been working on themselves, okay? They could have been really trying to figure out how to keep up in a damn conversation. You know what I'm saying? How to work on their confidence to stop making all these damn excuses. That's what they should have been working on. But nah, they was out here doing low vibration ass shit, being out here in these streets, okay? And while they did that, Scorpio, while they was out here in these streets, okay, being low vibrational, Scorpio, they never had time for you. See, this when those excuses came in. They ain't want to tell you, Scorpio, what shit. Me and my friends out here doing low vibration ass shit. You know, we fucking hoes, tricking off. You know what I'm saying? We out here just doing dumb shit, you know. They didn't want to tell you this. So this person just always made a lot of excuses to why they couldn't be available for you, okay? And when they did that, Scorpio, this made you question your worth. And shit, I don't know about y'all, but dealing with my twin, I ain't never had nobody who couldn't make time for me. You know what I'm saying? Not to just brag on myself and them and shit. You know, if I'm dealing with a person and shit, I want to chill. We want to do this. I want to do that. Like, shit, they was willing and able, but not this mug. Not the twin, okay? This is someone who made me question my worth because I compared him. You know, to past men that I've dealt with, I was like, well, damn. Ain't nobody else never made me feel like this. You know what I'm saying? Like, nah, them shits didn't work out either, but at least these niggas made time. Ooh, excuse me. At least these men made themselves available. They tried to made it seem like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he didn't even try, you know? For some of you guys, someone here could have talked shit about you, Scorpio. For some of you, you found out, or you will be finding out who this person was and the shit that they said. And they're going to regret this shit, because they're going to have to eat them fucking words. You hear me? Someone here, Scorpio, didn't use protection. Now, they could have been out here when they was being low vibrational. This could have been someone, when they didn't use protection, they could have gotten someone pregnant. They could have caused some type of STD. Okay, we're going to hope it's curable. But someone here, Scorpio, regrets they didn't use protection because I feel like some good shit didn't happen after that, okay? Someone here, Scorpio, thought the grass would be greener dealing with a third party, okay? So some of you guys, this person wasted a lot of time dealing with this third party, okay? Choosing this convenient situation over love just because they thought the grass was going to be greener on the other side and she was dead. That shit was brown and shit. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't all green like it is on your side, Scorpio. They grass dead as fuck, and they ain't even know this shit. And for some of you guys, this was your twin flame, and they ran away from you. They ran away from true love. Just like I said, they chose a convenient situation with this third party where they didn't have to change, they didn't have to grow, they didn't have to heal, they didn't have to work on themselves. They chose that situation versus running toward their twin, which was going to help them heal, help them evolve, help them grow, help them become the best version of themselves, okay? All right, so let's pull from this awakened soul. So let's look at future energy now, okay? And this could be how you feel in Scorpio, or this could be how this person is feeling, okay? Let's look at future energy now. We know we don't look at the past, and we know what happened in the past. So let's see what's going to happen in the future. So we're going to pull some messages from my awakened soul, okay? If anything has been resonating with you guys so far, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and comment. Messages for my Scorpios, Holy Spirit. Tell us about how this person is evolved. What is going on with this person now in the future? Because we know Scorpio, they want to reconnect with you, okay? This person has not moved on, but shit, let's see what's going on with them, though, okay? All right, Holy Spirit, what's going on with this person? Future energy. What's going on in the future for my Scorpios? Okay. So, Scorpio, this person's saying that they want to settle down and have a family together. Okay, so some of you guys, you could possibly have kids with this person, okay? Or some of you guys will be blending families, okay? You may already have kids, they may have kids, okay? You're gonna blend those two families together, okay? I feel like, Scorpio, this connection right here really transforms your life, especially if this is your divine counterpart, okay? A lot of the twin, Scorpio, it's mistaken that when you meet your twin, it's all about you and this person coming together and all that blah, blah, blah. No, it's not. The connection that you have with your twin, Scorpio, that's the connection that transforms your life. It changes you from the inside out, and it transforms you to be the best version of yourself so that spirit can set you on your divine path, okay? So that is why a lot of us were connected with our twin, even though it wasn't a good experience we had. But if it wasn't for that fucked up experience that we had with this person, Scorpio, we never would have got set or put on our divine path, okay? We never would be setting ourselves and preparing ourselves for these blessings in the future, okay? All right, tell us more, Holy Spirit. What is it that Scorpio needs to know? I have changed so much. And okay. So Scorpio, I feel like some of you guys, you've changed so much, okay? Even your physical appearance is starting to change. Some of you guys, like I said, you could have lost some weight. You could be really toning up. Your skin could be even clearer. Your hair growing. It's like your physical appearance is changing so much that you're starting not to even recognize yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like you're starting to see like, damn, I really am changing. Like when you really grow and evolve, Scorpio, from the inside, that shit shows on the outside, okay? All right, Scorpio, I want to be the only man or woman in your life. So now, Scorpio, this person wants to come in and do damage control, okay? So this person know that they fucked up real bad in the past, okay? So now this person wants to come in and do damage control because they want to be the only man or the only woman in your life here, okay? I'm truly sorry for breaking your heart and making you feel like you were not good enough, okay? So this person realizes when they made themselves not available to you, when they had you questioning your worth, and they were talking about you, when they chose a third party over you, Scorpio, this really broke your heart. You know what I'm saying? And this person is truly sorry for making you feel like you weren't good enough, because Scorpio, you always were good enough. This person just was too blind to see that you were good enough, okay? All right, y'all. So let's see what signs we come out. Who is this reading about for my Scorpios, Holy Spirit? Okay, we have Gemini, Sag, Leo, Virgo. We have Gemini, Aquarius, Libra, Leo. And we also have Aries, Cancer, Capricorn, and Scorpio. All right, you guys, I love you. And until next time, stay blessed.